Hey, hello there. My name is Andrew. I'm a professional photographer and filming director. Now, one of the things that I do almost every day, photo editing and image retouching. And this is where I want to introduce to you one of my most favorite apps, Pixlr. Pixlr is an online photo editing software which is free, and Pixlr is now in its latest version called Pixlr 2022. And let me share with you why I like Pixlr. Number one, Pixlr is a freemium, which means it's a free software that you can use completely free. Second reason why I like Pixlr, you don't need to install anything. It's an online web-based application, which means that all you need to do is fire up your favorite browser and head on to Pixlr's link. And you can sign in, log in from there, and which is great because there are days that I don't have my computer with me, and I've been switching computers a lot because we change filming location and shooting location from one studio to another. I don't need to install any app on other people's computer. All I need to do is point my browser, log in, and that's it. I'm ready to go. And the third thing that I like about Pixlr, it comes with two powerful versions. The first one is called Pixlr X. Pixlr X is great in making posters and banners and those social media ads that we do a lot. More on Pixlr X in a separate video. And then we have Pixlr E. Pixlr E is a full-fledged advanced photo editing and image retouching app. And in this video, I'd like to share with you the powerful features that we have in Pixlr E, the advanced photo editing and retouching app that has this cool artificial intelligence feature embedded in its 2022 version. So let's get started with some of the features and tools that I frequently use in Pixlr E 2022 that will save you tons of work. I'd like to say a word of thank you to Imagine Lab Private Limited and also Pixlr for this collaboration. So you're gonna be greeted with this main page here, which has one button, open image. I'm gonna click on that and open a photo of one of my favorite model, Emma. And I'm gonna resize this to full HD because opening it just full resolution is just gonna be too big. I don't need that now. And the image is not auto-rotated. Easy, just head onto your page and flip it clockwise. There we go. And the first tool I'm gonna show you in Pixlr 2022 is this cutout or mask tool. Click on this. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna remove this white background of Emma and replace it with a background. And just right below the main menu, you're gonna have the option toolbar. Choose Magic Mask. Let me show you what it does. And don't forget to click on this, which is Remove from Mask. Let me show you what this is. Click on the background, the gray color that I don't want. Selectively go to the places that you'd want to remove the gray background, and voila, that's how it looks like. When you see a checkered background like this, that means that Emma's layer or your subject's layer is transparent. Now it's time for us to choose and drop in the background. I'm gonna choose a background like this, the seaside. You can drop it into the photo, and don't forget to click this. And now you notice that we have two layers. The beach photo is at the top and Emma is at the bottom. But because the beach photo is so big, I need to resize this realistically. I'm transforming the photo, moving it, adjusting it the way I think it will look good with Emma in front. Okay, I'm gonna do this now. As you can see, Pixlr 2022 supports layer and the beach photo is at the top layer. So drag this down, and this will make Emma at the top layer and the beach layer at the back. See, that's an easy way to remove background and replace it with the background that you like. Oh, one word of caution. Like all background replacements, sometimes you will miss certain spots on your subject that will not show the background. So in this case, I'm gonna zoom in here and take a look at this spot on Emma's hair here. You notice that there's still the gray spot. So I'm gonna show you how you do this. Go back to the cutout tool, and this time, select the magic mask and go in here and select this. And there you go, it's revealing the background now. But then again, look at the finger here. You notice that something is amiss. And then what you do this time is I'm gonna show you another feature. Choose the draw mask, which is actually a brush icon, and select the brush size which is appropriate. And don't forget one more thing, click this. add to mask instead of removing mask. And brush away this imperfection. And Emma gets her fingernail back. Oh, there's an important thing I want to share with you. Did you know that Pixlr 2022 has a premium version? And if you sign up to it, you get thousands of templates. And then you get this one-click background remover, which I'm going to show you later, and hundreds of exclusive fonts. Don't forget that you have features like dispersion, which I totally love this dispersion. Now let's go back to Emma's photo, and let me show you that one-click background removal. Now you notice that once you sign up and become a premium user, and you're going to see this little button here, AI Auto Background Removal. And here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go to the history section here and go all the way up as if I just opened a photo with a gray background. And let me show you how cool this artificial intelligence background one-click removal is. It's working. It's doing it. There you go. It's that simple. But then of course, if you zoom in and look at the hair section, there'll be areas that it misses out. All you need to do is do the same thing with the brush and use the magic mask to remove it. But hang on a minute. You will notice some imperfection despite that the AI is doing so well. I'm going to show you how you can undo this. Click on the brush and click on the add to mask option. Just zoom into this section and brush back this, and that's how you get her fingers perfect again. And there you go, faster and equally as good. All right, the next tool, I'm gonna show you my most frequently used tool for portrait retouching. Instead of clicking open, I'm gonna drag this, and you can also open files this way. Rotate this to the right orientation. And let's zoom in and let's see the imperfection that we wanna work on this time. There's one on the nose, and there's a mole I want to remove. Now hit on to the toolbar here and select Heal. Now you're presented with three choices: Spot, Soft, and Object. Whenever you see a yellow bar up here, this is a premium feature. Now let's go to Spot. And you can choose the brush size, reduce this. Make sure you choose a size which is not too big. And zoom in and just click. There you go. Now let's remove the mole here. Click, done. That's about it. You can just keep on doing this and get perfect skin for all your portraits. Now let me show you one more tool that I frequently use in portrait retouching, which is Liquify. What it does, it allows you to reshape and move pixels on your portrait. Now head on to the toolbar here and look for this three wavy line, and that's liquification. What I like about this is that it doesn't open another window like most image retouching software. You can straight away liquify from here. I'm gonna zoom right in and do a few things. One of the things that I normally do is to correct the eyebrow a little bit. I'm gonna adjust the brush size, not too big, and just nudge it a little. That's right, let's make the eyes a little bit bigger for the model here. Everybody loves big eyes. And let's nudge the lips a little bit to give her a little bit more smiley face. And reshape the jaw a little bit. Oops! You can always undo by pressing Ctrl Z or Command Z on your keyboard. And that's what Liquify does. And one last thing, let's make this index finger a little bit longer and softer. And better. Longer fingers, nicer pose. Okay, remember I spoke about the object removal in the Heal tool if you're a premium subscriber. Let me show you what it does. And here's a photo of Emma, and look at the trash. All you need to do is just paint this over. You will see a green bar of Pixlr processing this, and voila. That's how you remove trash easily, just by painting over with the object removal tool. Alright, apart from touching up blemishes and liquefying our subjects, one of the more frequent things that we do as photographers to make our photos more stunning is to do sky replacement. That's right, you heard me correct. I'm going to show you how we combine a few tools in Pixlr 2022 and get this done. So, this is a photo. I find that the sky can be a little bit more dramatic. So, we're going to head on to the cutout tool, like what you did earlier, and we're going to remove the sky completely. Right, don't panic when you see this. All you need to do is just change the brush tool, adjust the size, and paint away the imperfection. Now, by adjusting the softness of the brush, I can actually soften how much I remove the background. Great, I've removed the original sky. Now head on to your layer and add a new layer. So as you can see, the top layer is now a transparent layer. All we need to do is head on back to the tool menu, select this gradient tool, and at the tool option, you're gonna see this bar, gradient. Select this. The first color on the left-hand side indicates the start of the gradient. We're gonna pick a lighter sky blue. Okay, this one will do. And then we go to the next one and select a darker blue. Remember this rule. Sky goes from light blue to darker blue as we progress towards the space. Now good, make sure that you're on the topmost layer and at an angle, we're gonna drag this from bottom to top. The higher you move, the more the gradient is. So we're gonna drag this down and there you have it. Yeah, I know it looks a little bit dramatic, but well, it's a show and tell to show you what you can do with Pixlr. Okay, since we're in the mood of having fun and getting crazy sky, let's try something a little bit more dramatic. Head on to the gradient and choose from the template of gradients that we have here. All right, I like this color. Let's see whether it makes the background more dramatic now. Perfectly psychedelic. Hey, one of the best ways to get the attention of your viewers to your photos is to saturate colors or desaturate them and get this pot color effect. So if you look at this photo, it's really nice, but somehow the colorful background just kind of drowned Emma away and you cannot really focus the attention on her. So head on to the sponge tool. What you can do is you can desaturate color, clicking this, decrease color, and then choose saturation and adjust the brush size and the strength. I'm gonna adjust the strength to the highest possible. I'm gonna remove all the color except the squares in the center. Let's start. As you can see, just by brushing over, I can remove the sky. It's now black and white. Great, as you can see, I've removed all the colors from all the boxes and just leaving the 9 boxes and Emma colored. This is called spot color. But let me show you how you can make this better. Somehow I find that the colors are just not strong enough. Head on to the top, choose increase, and adjust your brush size, decrease the strength, and just paint over Emma and the 9 boxes now. And just by doing so, I just enhance on the saturation on the 9 boxes and Emma. And that's how you attract your viewers' eyes to a certain part of the photo by using the sponge tool of Pixlr. Right, the next tool, color replacement. What do I mean by this? One of the most frequent thing that we are asked to do as photographers is to change color. So if you look at this shot, I love this. The green paddy fields at the back is just fantastic, but Emma's, the models, her red dress is just a little bit too complementary, which means that the color is just too much striking difference from the background. I'm gonna change this to, well, okay, let's try blue. Click on this tool here called color replacement. And don't forget, head on up to change the brush size. And the tolerance is a value that you need to play around with. Lower tolerance means that you're gonna get more specific to that color. Higher means that the brush would have a higher tolerance and don't really care. So I'm gonna bring this down to be more precise. And that's it. You might be tempted to choose the brighter red here and start painting here. Don't do this. Choose the middle shade of red, which is here. The reason you do this is that the brush can now cover the shadow tone and also the highlight. Let's try this now. All you need to do is just paint over. Choosing the wrong spot is just gonna end up making your color replacement not so realistic. Wow, I like this now. Hey professional photographers, you work on photos in a batch at one go, applying the same action to a series of photos. That saves you a lot of time. If you're subscribed to the premium edition of Pixlr E, then you can work on 50 photos at one go in a single batch action. And if you're not, you can still do so, but up to 3 photos. I bet you're impressed with the features of Pixlr E. If you are, hurry, head on to this website now all you need to do is start enjoying Pixlr for free is to click sign up, fill up with your email address, set a password to it, and you're good to go. And while you're at it, don't forget to check out Pixlr Premium. Though it's a subscription base, it's truly affordable because billing is just done once a year. Check out the price. And then with this, you're going to get these artificial intelligent features that's going to even save you more time, like what I did in this video. So hurry, head on to Pixlr, start using Pixlr, and make photo editing and retouching effortless. I'll see you soon in the next video.